Anti-government protesters in Thailand are calling for reforms to the monarchy and an end to the country's strict lèse majesté law. And many have been arrested on sedition charges. So what is the lèse majesté law? The lèse majesté law has been present in Thai criminal codes since the early 1900s, when Thailand was known as Siam. It was designed to protect the royal family from criticism and defamation. Monarchy is a sacred institution in Thailand. Thai kings held absolute power for hundreds of years until the 1932 revolution, when Thailand officially became a constitutional monarchy. Under the kingdom's lèse majesté law and section 112 of the country's penal code, defaming monarchs is a crime punishable by up to 15 years in prison. The law has been increasingly used since the 2014 military coup, when Prime Minister Prayuth Chan-o-cha came to power. Critics say that the military-backed government has used this law to stifle dissent and clamp down on free speech since then. They also say that there is no clear definition of what constitutes an insult to the monarchy. Under this law, complaints can be filed by anyone against anyone, and they are always formally investigated by the police. Those arrested can be denied bail or held in pre-trial detention for longer periods. Trials are often held behind closed doors in military courts, where defendants' rights are limited. Between the 2014 coup and early 2018, at least 98 lèse majesté charges were filed according to a legal database by Thai watchdog iLaw. In 2014, a complaint was filed against a woman who wore black on then King Bhumibol Adulyadej's birthday. And in 2015, a man who wrote a sarcastic online post about the late king's dog was charged. In 2017, the United Nations Special Rapporteur on the Promotion of Freedom of Opinion and Expression called on the Thai government to amend this law, saying the lèse majesté provisions have no place in a democratic country. Reports say that the use of this law has slowed in recent years because of His Majesty's mercy, but critics warn that other legal routes are being used by the authorities to target dissent, which carries a term of up to 7 years. In March 2018, two men were tried for burning pictures of the king. A local court dropped the royal insult charge, but found the two guilty of being part of a criminal organization and arson.